For more videos on people's struggles, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Faith leaders and low-wage workers took to the streets of the US Capitol on August 2nd in defense of voting rights and for a minimum wage of $15 per hour. The National Moral Monday protest was organized by the Poor People's Campaign as part of their season of non-violent moral direct action. Hundreds participated in the civil disobedience action organized outside the Capitol. Around 200 protesters were arrested by the police, including renowned ministers and civil rights activists Reverend Barber, Reverend Liz Theo Harris, and Reverend Jesse Jackson. The protest's key demands are to pass all provisions of the For the People Act. The For the People Act aims to combat voter suppression, reduce the role of money in politics, and limit gerrymandering by state governments. The For the People Act will also standardize federal election rules and reform the Federal Election Commission. It also limits states' ability to redistrict without federal approval, reformed campaign financing provisions, and set up new ethics rules for major federal posts. End the filibuster. The bill has been stalled in the 50-50 Senate because of the filibuster, and thus Democrats can't push the legislation through without Republican support. Filibuster is a political procedure which allows members of Congress to delay the passing of a vote or law by debating over it for an extended period of time. The third demand is to fully restore the Voting Rights Act of 1965. The historic law passed on August 6, 1965 was one of the key victories of the civil rights movement of the 1960s. It prohibits state and local governments from passing laws or policies that could deny citizens the right to vote based on race. The law was significantly debilitated in the ruling in 2013, and voters' rights advocates argue that today, voters have even less protections than they did when the law was passed. The fourth demand is to raise the federal minimum wage to $15 per hour. Social movements have been long demanding a federal minimum living wage for $15 per hour. The Poor People's Campaign's season of nonviolent moral direct action comes at a time of increased attacks by conservatives on the voting rights of marginalized communities and a deep economic crisis in the country, first and foremost affecting working class people. They mobilized just days after the country's eviction moratorium had expired, which put at least 3.6 million tenants at risk of eviction until its emergency renewal on Tuesday, August 3rd. According to the Poor People's Campaign's research from 2019, more than 140 million people in the United States are below the poverty line, or one crisis away from being below the poverty line. With the economic impact of the pandemic, this number has grown exponentially.